three strikes, ain't got to lose. When it's all on the line, what you gonna do? Come on, I'm highly favored. Don't wanna play me, no conversation. Ain't got time for no debating. It's for the taking, no hesitation. Don't try my patience. I'ma pour out one for the set, boy, till there's nothing left. On a run to the bread until we all got them baguettes. Hear them footsteps coming, cause we coming for the check. We ain't gon' run, no, we don't hide. I could never switch, not a day in my life. Long as my dogs stay by my side. Yeah, we gon' ride till we die, die, die. Not a day in my life. Just know that my dogs stay by my side. Yeah, we gon' ride till we die, die, die.
We are just about 9 miles from downtown Manhattan as EA Sports brings you to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks. It's a short kick, taken at the 15. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. His first look is incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. Dancing to his left. And he goes out right around the 39. The improv act there, good for 9. And now they'll be looking at a 3rd and short, 3rd and 1. And just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. Play action. Now Wilson. And he's got Lockett. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Defense was thinking run, and they're dealt a pass of just under 20 yards. So in Jet territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 42-yard line. Open man is Ursula. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain there on the completion. 2nd and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. They go play action now. Wilson. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. An incomplete pass on second down. That muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. And it's hauled in by Nick Vanette. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 29-yard line. They go play action with Wilson. Steps away to his left. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And the Jets have recovered.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit and, in this case, lose the football?
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong. Ultimately, you've got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Check. Watch 54.
Silver.
Check three. 180.
Mike 54. Hey, Charlie.
Here we go.
So following the fumble recovery, here's Darnold. Being chased out left. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. That's Ziggy Ansah, the number 5 pick in 2013, credited with a sack. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. They'll run it with Bell. And he'll power his way up near the 25.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Darnold off the play fake to Bell. Now he'll let this one go. Deep left sideline. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. They'll run it with Bell. And this doesn't end well at all as they stop him far behind the line to gain.
I don't know why you would do that. It's almost guaranteed points the other way. I mean, I get it if it's a late game situation, maybe even fourth and inches. But boy, that's a huge risk to take.
Yeah, now they're set up in prime position going the other way. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Play action. It's Wilson. Flushed out right. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. The rushing numbers for Wilson may be down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. An inaugural trip to the red zone here for the Seahawks. They come up first and 10 at the 16. Here's Wilson, off play action. Escaping the pressure right, and he'll slide down to avoid the contact. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. From 10 yards out, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Myers connects on the PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned it 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
On second down now, it's Bell. He takes this for 3 to the 29. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Darnold from the gun. Oh, able to avoid him. Found his target. It's Anderson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The result, a first down, as a quick slant gets him 14. Off of play action, Darnold. They'll roll him out right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Looking to throw again on second down. Darnold flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle, and this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
They failed once in this spot earlier, but the offense will stay out to go for it on fourth down. They're going to go. It's Darnold. He finds his target. It's Crowder. 21 yards there. A big play on fourth down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now they'll try the sweep with Bell. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. On second down, it's Bell. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. Throwing here on third down, Darnold. Crowder's got it over the middle. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 22-yard line. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Fans, a reminder, I have a note card here that says ad-lib halftime previews. So I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Michael Kendricks showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of 4. Another try after the first down sack. Darnold. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone, and that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. The Jets on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 14.
Jumper, 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 jumper. Right there, 54, right there, right there. 54, Mike.
Darnold. A screen to Bell. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. The screen gets 7, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
So after that fourth down stop, Charles, you said it was almost guaranteed points the other way. Indeed, they do cash in, but only 3.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. They got the points, but it should have been more. With that type of field position, the setup that they had, I think it was almost a loss for them that they only got 3 instead of pushing across the line for a touchdown.
That's fielded in the end zone. take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try and move the ball and get in field goal range.
Yeah, you got the lead. It's definitely a thought. Let's go ahead and try and increase it. But at the same time, I don't like the odds. I don't like where they are in the field. Got the lead. They've done well in the first half. Don't mess it up and go into halftime looking at each other wondering what if.
We own them. Check 37.
One left.
To throw is Wilson. Off the play fake. Buying time to his left. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. 4 yards the pickup. First down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now it's Wilson. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line.
Got it.
57. Mike, 57.
Off the play fake. Wilson eluding the pressure right. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. That's caught at the 3. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. No move for the field goal unit. They're going to go here with 5 seconds left. Here's the sneak with Wilson. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally because they've done all nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. On second and 9. Darnold, that's complete. It's Bell. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. The tally there, minus 2 yards. Brings up third down. Now Darnold, really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing. Anderson loses the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Well, he did what he's known for. He made the catch, then he turned into a runner, took the contact, and coughed it up.
And all I remember as a player, when they catch the ball, those acrobatic guys catch it, you have to make them pay sometimes. You have to put it on them, big tackle, knock the ball free, anything you can do to slow them down. And partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. David Moore, the intended target, but now it'll be third down. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Now Wilson. Flush. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. Tackle coming from the safety, Trey Flowers. On second and seven, Darnold escaping the pressure right. And some room to work. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains. Now a first down carry by Bell. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. From the 41, Darnold. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right. And this is caught inside the five. A big pickup of 38.
They're still looking for their first touchdown of the game, and for a second, I thought they had it right there.
Looking on the sideline, it's finally good to see nods of approval. It's a welcome sign of life that this offense needed. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Jets have taken the lead. A 1-yard run on first down, another yard that gets him into the end zone on second down. Maybe not much for the yards per carry average, but hey, 6 points.
Yeah, bottom line is it doesn't matter there. You've got to find a way to wedge it into the end zone. Yards per carry, that's out the window. How do you score? And on the second down, they had something going. They got a yard before. They thought they could do it again, and they got it done.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? Eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf, 63 yards, and the Seahawks are going to retake the lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
Watch the twist. Watch the twist. Pop, pop, motion, 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 motion.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line. Again, it's Bell. Now Bell, him. He lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Check. You ready?
the fumble recovery. It's Wilson, flushed out right. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. It's a good pickup on the ground of 7 yards, and time has run out on this third quarter. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter. Now it's Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. It's a 7-yard gain and good enough to move the chains. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Forced out to his left. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold it for a short gain when he took off running.
And it's caught. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. 11 yards there. First down. So first and goal. 6 points here would go a long way. And he's across the chalk into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Seahawks capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. Extra point up and through by Myers. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken about 7 yards deep. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Good word. I like it, man, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
From the 29, Darnold. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Jaron Reed muscles his way in for the sack. Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack. Here's Darnold. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Shaquille Griffin knocking it away that time in coverage. Looking to erase a two-score deficit here in the fourth quarter, going for some big plays.
Yeah, they certainly were. They just decided one shot, didn't they? Forget trying to move the ball downfield in small little increments. Let's go for the big one. But how about the defense playing situational football, looking at the scoreboard and realizing, what can hurt us most? The deep shot.
You saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Tedrick Thompson picks it.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 23. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. He's at the 30, 10, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. Three touchdown passes now. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
This is taken about 7 yards deep.
The Jets take over. We got this.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you're looking at your plays. Oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball.
Under pressure now, Darnold, and he goes down. Cassius Marsh just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Jaron Reed able to drop him that time for his 2nd sack of the evening. Ziggy Ansah.
Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like. Fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like. Every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my numbers going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You say that you ballin', keep it real, though. Ay, why I never saw you in the field, though? Ay, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grindin' for a minute, and I'm still gone. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss, let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
Yeah. It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. The two teams emerging from their respective tunnels a minute ago to the approval of this Baltimore crowd. They're all set as their Ravens will match up with the Seattle Seahawks. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the shotgun, Wilson. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle. Now a throw left sideline here is complete. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. DK Metcalf, 69 yards. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. This is Mark Ingram, and he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Here's Jackson to throw, flush to his right. Able to slither by, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
Not sure how you feel about it, but to me, I think we're seeing it in front of our eyes. This league continues to change. Look at the moves you ordinarily get from a running back from the quarterback position.
Yeah, that's like a Le'Veon Bell type move right there. But you're exactly right. The game's kind of evolving in that way, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the quarterback is rapidly becoming an extra running back as well.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again. Jackson. Dancing to his left. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. To throw again on second down. Jackson eluding the pressure right. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Now a play fake here on first down. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Throwing again on second down. Jackson escaping. The ball comes out, and the Seahawks have picked it up.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Here's Wilson. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. Give him 30 yards there. Charles, you talk so much about quick change plays. There's one right there. You get the turnover, and boom, hit him with a big one.
And defenses plan for this all the time. They work on it in practice. But in the middle of a game, when that quick change takes place, oftentimes guys aren't as focused as they need to be.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. That one going to be complete to David Moore. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. Wilson now already over 100 yards passing in just this first quarter. It's first and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Steps away to his left. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. This is caught, and he is in for the Seattle touchdown. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. They've got to be thrilled on the road right now. Touchdown, turnover, touchdown, and quickly trying to make it 14-0.
Yeah, and mentioned it already. On the road, to be able to go into someone else's house and establish a start like that, obviously your confidence rises in a big way, and you're putting some doubt in their minds.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they got across the 50 last time, but fumbled and turned it over, so they'll be looking to have a short-term memory here, Mr. Davis. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. So more problems here in this first quarter. Already two scores down, and here they give away the football.
And if I'm the head coach, I think it's time to start lighting a fire under some of these guys. Now, you have to do it within your personality. They can't perceive it as fake. But I'd go get after some guys, because they don't look ready to play to me. They look flat, uninspired. It's time to get moving.
Check down.
After the interception, here's Wilson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So he can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know. But you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. Flush to his right. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Brandon Carr. 14-0 is the score after one on EA Sports. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic Oath, first do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Diggs. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out. And by a few inches, that'll be a first down. Now it's Jackson being chased out left. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down. Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson eluding the pressure right. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
Looked to me like the adopter of my kindergarten teacher always said, if at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield, and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah, I don't think it was a big adjustment, but much more emphasis on making sure they knew where he was when he decided to take off and go.
That one good for 24 yards. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff.
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
To throw again on second down, Jackson. Buying time to his left. And this is caught at the 8. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. That one covers 29 yards. First down. Now it's Jackson. And he will score. Touchdown, Baltimore. Taking it in from 7 yards away as they are now on the board here in the first half.
Defensively by now, you know his ability. You know he has it in him to take off and run.
Yeah, because they knew coming into this game, but we've already seen examples in this contest that he can run the football.
I think they're going to examine different ways to rush him now. Are they going to do it with different lanes? Are they going to use a spy? But they have to come up with options because right now, he's hurting them.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Going up top. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. After the interception, here's Jackson forced out to his left. He's going deep for Brown. It got his man complete. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play that time for the Ravens. 44 yards. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. The quick feet by Jackson, and inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson, escaping the pressure right. And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. Bobby Wagner, the former second rounder out of Utah State, with a sack. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Jackson from the shotgun. And all the way going to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. They'll look to run with Ingram, and he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out as his guys can now take the lead with the extra point. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Under a minute to play here in the half. Time for a late drive.
It makes sense when you think about it. Hey, try and get a field goal. Give yourself a lead going into the half. But if you're going to do this, you better have supreme trust in your quarterback. Supreme trust in the guy who's going to handle the football. Because if you turn it over here, not only do you go in down at the half, you've given the momentum squarely to your opponent.
Alert.
Now Wilson on first down. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And finally down at the 32-yard line. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Wilson now 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here. Final play of the half, it's Wilson. And a big loss here as he's taken down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The offense back out there at the line ready for their next drive. They have the lead, now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separate.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Bobby Wagner, his second sack of the night. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the... Throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And an alley to run. And now look at him go. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, we know this defense has athleticism. Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism because you and I both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
Well, I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on.
Fine. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Back to the air, Jackson following the pick six. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. On first and 10, it's Jackson, eluding the pressure right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Michael Kendricks coming in to drop him. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15.
Check 52. Watch twist.
Go.
To throw is Jackson. Flushed out right. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They snap it at one. Now it's Jackson. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Michael Kendricks able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Here's Sam Cook now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And they'll go ahead and down this one right on the chalk of the 20-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
Well, Charles, while we have a moment, you know what we need to do here is give a nod to the new Hall of Famers who were brought into Canton and inducted on August the 3rd. Champ Bailey, Pat Bowlen, Gil Brandt, Tony Gonzalez, Ty Law, Kevin Mawai, Ed Reed, and Johnny Robinson, all part of the class.
Fantastic class. When you talk about guys who played at a top level, obviously, they're Hall of Famers. But what I found interesting about it is you've got a great pass catcher, the best pass catching tight end in history in Tony Gonzalez. How would he like to work against this secondary? Champ Bailey and Ty Law at corner, Ed Reed and Johnny Robinson at safety. Good luck trying to get open against those four. What a matchup that would have been. But it was a terrific night for those gentlemen. Congratulations. And of course, Ed Reed's bust will go down in history because they got the hair exactly right, and Ed had a ball up there in his Hall of Fame speech.
And remember, next year they're going to celebrate the centennial year of the NFL with a special class of 20, so get ready for those speeches.
I wonder if they'll do it like Johnny Robinson this year, who actually submitted a video instead of going up to the podium, and his speech was about 5 minutes long, which is probably about the right length.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. Throwing again on second and 10. Wilson.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. Quick slant, caught by Moore. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
Let's go, let's do this.
The Seahawks moving pretty well through the air. Another first down. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter.
And let's pin the mirror. Let's check.
First down, Wilson. He's got the first down inside the 10. This will be caught inside the 10. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll try and run for it with Penny. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. Here's Wilson. Escaping the pressure right.
This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. Able to get 9 out of that pitch and catch, but now 3rd and goal.
36 power. 12.
On 3rd and goal, Wilson. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the 8. Chris Wormley with a big-time sack on 3rd down. It's a loss of 7. Jason Myers on for the field goal. And that hits the right upright but goes in anyway. Oh, friendly bounce there that could have gone either way easily, but he gets it to go. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. This fielded at the 2. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means...
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Michael Kendricks in there to get him yet again. That is his 3rd sack tonight. They can't figure him out. To try again after the sack, Jackson, and that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's 3rd down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line with a sack at Ziggy Ansah. They'll try and throw for it, but Jackson. Dancing to it, and he's going to go down again. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got it 1st and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. From the shotgun, Wilson. His pass caught at the 4. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. That'll bring up 2nd and goal after the gain of 5. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's 2nd and 1. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Call it no gain that time, and now it's 3rd and goal. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is bad. He will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Rashad Penny taking it in. Here, the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge.
And for a 3rd time tonight, he's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And they will be set up now as he...
I'm not afraid to die. ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
We are at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up with the Arizona Cardinals. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Throwing on first is Wentz. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. The catch and run pays off for 29 yards. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Wentz gonna throw. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. But it's going to be second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Wentz again here on second and 10. And he finds a man with a crossing route. Nelson Aguilar, 56 yards, and they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Let's make no bones about it. On paper, they're the better team. They're at home. That's a strong opening drive.
And just think how many times we've seen this type of a matchup. Just what you said, better team at home should steam.
Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10.
If we had a dollar for every time we heard a team talk about explosive plays and how valuable they are, we probably wouldn't have to work very much. And we just saw a big one there. And then they tried to go explosive again, going for two.
Yeah, is that a little too risky, you think? Just kick the extra point?
And you know, I'm all about getting points. And if I feel good about my kicker, I go ahead and do that. But with that ball at the 2-yard line, going for two, I think it's awfully tempting for teams nowadays.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. The first carry now. This is Johnson. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. So from the 36 now, first and 10. the ground. This is Johnson. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They give to Johnson going right. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. He may try and run for this. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Third and medium, they opted to run instead of pass, and it worked. First down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. First down, Murray. And now he'll tuck it and run. That goes for 14 yards. First down, Cardinals.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Murray now on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Derek Barnett able to maneuver in for the sack. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Fake handoff to Johnson. Now here's Murray. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Mills, and his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. Well, not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And finally, he goes out of bounds right at the 35-yard line.
That's a great job of working the sideline right there. I love how he tracked the football the whole way. Just reached up and pulled it in. Had excellent field presence to understand where he was in order to make that play happen.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. Now Wentz. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35.
Let's get it together, defense. Let's get it together.
Tight down the man inside. Down the man.
Here's Wentz to throw. Escaping the pressure right. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, 35 yards. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. They're going to try and run. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. And I guess that makes up for the earlier missed two-point try here to get him to 14.
Yeah, that aggressiveness, it reminds me a lot of when for two was really starting to work for them. In this case now, maybe the two for one is coming into play in the NFL. Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these team special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Ricky Seals-Jones, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Oh, now Murray has it stripped, but I think a Cardinal was able to gain possession, yes, so they will hold on to the ball.
Keep playing hard, fellas, all day. Woo! Let's get it.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. From just shy of midfield, Murray flushed to his right. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Murray now. And that will be incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces 4th down. Throwing now is Murray. Looking for Crabtree, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. Crabtree the target on that one. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a cornerback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets, but oftentimes your playbook hasn't expanded to give you full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. 3 touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels.
And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you just called it desperation time.
I think you did.
But let's face it, you mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Now a 3rd down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. More problems here on 3rd down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on 3rd down, it makes it hard to win a ball game, because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. Touchdown, Cardinals! Christian Kirk, 72 yards, as they are now on the board here in the first half. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
You get locked in.
Wentz now on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And complete to Zach Ertz. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. The big gainer there on the catch and run. 37 yards.
Well, you don't have to be a genius to watch this game and figure out they've had plenty of success moving the football here in the first half. We've seen exhibits A, B, C, and right on down the line, haven't we?
Yeah, we just saw exhibit Z right there. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Chandler Jones, one of the best athletes to ever come out of Rochester, New York, in for the sack. After the sack on first down, Wentz. And I think the ball's out. And the Cardinals have got it, going the other way. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Flushed out right. He gets this one to Michael Crabtree. A huge play there for Arizona. 47 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
Following the penalty, it's Johnson. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first. This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. Kyler Murray with his second touchdown here in this first half, as his guys are back within a single score. This time, the extra point up and good, and that will shave one more off this lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. From the 21, it's second and 10.
Hey, red 5-2, I'm here. Fran. Here we go.
Wentz off the fake handoff to Howard. Steps away to his left. It's complete left side to Aguilar. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 22 yards there, a first down. Wentz now on first down. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
The secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
Escaping the pressure right, and seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 40. Wentz. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. That's going to be caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Carson Wentz with touchdown pass number 4 on the afternoon. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for 2. Now Wentz again. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker Jordan Hicks. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Let's go. The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Time here for likely a couple plays if they want it, but with the field position what it is, maybe better suited to just sit on this one?
I'm with you totally. I would sit on it and get into the locker room and start over. But if they do decide to try and make a play, we know what the basics are. You run draw, you run screen. I would maybe run a little swing pass and try and get my lineman out in space and see if they can chop a hole into the secondary and see if he can run a little bit.
On 2nd and 9, Murray. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. A final shot before half for Murray. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down, 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is a I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive, and we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. He'll buy some time right. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It'll be an Arizona first down on a gain of 17. Murray now on first down. It's complete to his tight end, Charles Clay. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Here's Murray.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Let's go.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
Screenplay, Johnson. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play.
Hey, 4 down.
They'll try to run it in. Johnson. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Defense keeps him out of the end zone there. Now, will they go for it? And if so, can they do it one more time?
Yeah, I just don't know if it's worth it going for it, because what we've seen from the defense so far, every gap is taken care of. Everyone is sound in their coverage. No one is breaking free. And those ball carriers are getting tagged. If I were them, I'd think very hard about just taking 3 points and taking their dignity and moving on.
And the ball's at the 2, spotted at the 2, so a pretty good chunk to go. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And, Charles, you'd have to think this is where you want to start taking some time off the clock.
Oh, definitely, because you got the lead, right? You take a good look up there, and you say, okay, what do we need to do here? Well, you're not in full-out protect mode. You want to make sure you run it, throw it safe, take some time off, and eat it up.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Well, let's have some fun while we have a minute here. Fantasy drafts are in full swing. I know I've got my family fantasy draft coming up, Charles. Who would be your top 3 picks? I know that you're a noted fantasy football expert, so who would you take?
Well, you've got to start with guys who are going to touch the football and put it in the end zone, right? You got to score points. How about Saquon Barkley with the Giants? You know he's going to run it. He's going to catch it. When they get desperate, they may actually have him return it as well. Alvin Kamara is an absolute matchup nightmare for everyone. And Christian McCaffrey, did he ever come off the field last year? And, you know, this guy, he's a threat to be a 1,000-yard runner and a 1,000-yard receiver, as is Kamara. So this is going to be fun to watch. I can't wait to see those guys do their thing. But there are plenty of other guys out there, too. If Zeke comes along, you got to take him. Melvin Gordon, if they both come to camp, we'll see how that works out. How about Todd Gurley and his health? Because when he touches the ball, great things usually happen.
And then wondering, someone like Le'Veon Bell took the year off, now a new offense. But if he starts going like he used to, he's obviously going to be a good one.
Fresh legs is what you're counting on with Le'Veon Bell, and a fresh start in New York with the Jets. And if you're looking for an exciting rookie, remember this. Kyler Murray's going to get the ball from the first snap, and they're going to leave him in there throughout. And as long as he stays healthy, he's going to pitch it around the park a bunch. Don't be surprised if he gets a little love, too.
Throwing now is Wentz. Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And they will score. It's a pick six for the Cardinals touchdown.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's Oski. And that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oski.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And they've got the lead here getting late into the third quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that. But the rushing game, almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish this game off, they need the running game to come back to life. They need to get sparked that way. Take some time off the clock and keep the ball away from their opponents.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Throwing again on second down. Wentz, he's going to let this go deep for Jackson. That's caught inside the 20. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Deshaun Jackson, 69 yards. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. To throw, it's Wentz. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Elliott now to kick this one away.
We play to win. Let's go.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him with contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about that. Super tough.
Now Murray, and he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Rodney McLeod, trying to get it to Clay that time. Well, that puts a little bit of a wrinkle in their comeback bid.
Yeah, everything had turned around for them, hadn't it? I mean, things were now going their way. But you did mention it's a wrinkle in their comeback bid. It's not the death knell for them by any stretch, but now they've got some extra work to do in order to climb all the way back.
Flush to his right. It's complete. It's Sproles. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it'll make it second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Now it's the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles. And this play a lot like the previous one, thanks to that stout Cardinal defense. Back-to-back, they've been tackled behind the line. On third and long, it's Wentz. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Robert Alford. And he will take it out to the 25-yard line. So, my goodness, I would have thought this possible not too long ago, but that turnover there means we have a game again.
Yeah, it's been a completely different team here in the second half. I just wonder on the other side of the field, where the starters telling the backups, get ready, you're going to get some playing time. And now guess what? Hope they didn't cut the tape off of their wrists and ankles. They've got to go back out there and play.
And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 30-yard line.
Again, it's Johnson. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. The second down play results in a loss of 2 yards. To throw is Murray. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's 4th down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. And able to find Kirk complete. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Murray now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. First down, Murray. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Murray. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
He's going to let this go for the end zone. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Charles Clay, 48 yards. As they are now just an extra point away from making this a 3-point game. Here we go now as we get set for a big 2-point conversion. They'll try and run for it with Johnson. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Man, if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chile on the other side of the ball. Said, hey, he picked off the left.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Rodney Gunter in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Now Wentz. He finds Aguilar over the middle. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Guilt trip is here, baby. Guilt trip is here.
The Eagles on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
Go, go. Hey, Lou.
Wentz to throw. Aguilar has it. There he goes, right side. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Nelson Aguilar. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. So a big play for the Eagles now as they'll go for 2. Now Wentz throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Back to throw. Able to shake him off. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Give the sack to Fletcher Cox.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
The Cardinals forced to burn their third and final timeout as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. The Cardinals on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be third and forever. He'll look to throw. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. A big pickup, 18 yards, but they still stop him well short of the marker. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Murray and company going for it on fourth. He's going to let it fly. He's got a man complete. 20. And he's into the end zone. No flags. It's a touchdown. And now a two-point conversion. And we'll be tied here in the final minute.
Do they have one big call left? Here we go.
Listen to this crowd now. Their guys need a stop on this two-point conversion. And we've got movement by one of the big boys up front for Arizona. Flag comes in.
Well, that certainly comes under the heading of critical mistake, doesn't it, partner? You can't have that. You've got a chance to tie the ball game from the 2-yard line. Now you've got to go back to the 7-yard line and take the same chance.
Here we go, D. It's just me and you. It's just me and you. Check. Hop up.
Now Murray. Eluding the pressure right. And he's got it here for the 2 points, but there is a marker down, so we'll have to see what that's about. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. ...25 seconds to go. A must recover if they're going to have any chance.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. Wentz off the fake handoff to Howard. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. That's caught inside the 20. And he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. So the inability there to get the two-point conversion sort of leaves the door at least a little bit more ajar.
And puts the onus now on the kickoff team and the defense to make sure they don't give up a big play that puts them in position to lose.
Especially on this kickoff. Got to be careful. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short of the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted.
Honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young
incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials, I be murdering any flow. Yeah. I just had to let you know.
Yeah. Give me that work and I can sell it. I put it on the line like I ain't selfish, nah. The story flip if I let you tell it. Put my heart and soul in, so you feel it. I ain't never faking, I'm the realest. Tupac in the prison, man, claiming his innocence. Currently, I'm the greatest rapper in a sense. But any currency, I'm still guaranteed my wins. This is coming from within, I stuff for real, I don't pretend. When the OG's spilling knowledge, bet it's best you soak it in. I'm a prophet to them scholars, got them chakras opening. Got them fixing up their actors, now they truly focused in. I'm seeing 2020 visions. Daily manifesting on my premonitions. Best to keep it neutral, got my own religion. The brainwash, gotta make your own decision. My word is James Bond, I stay on the mission. Coming for the top position, ain't no competition, man. Pull up in the top, it's missing, fuck the opposition, man. All that lane switching, this is what the game is in. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials, I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. The young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You a joke like Chappelle Show. This so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D as their guys will do battle with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. This will be taken very short. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Hey, exit.
Snap comes at one. And now Brees. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. Brees now to throw.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody he just snuck out there and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Brees here finding Kamara. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game too. And they'll get this down to the 10. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. They've got a first and 10 from the 10. Throwing now is Brees. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown.
from 10 yards out. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Lutz good on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets. Past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 27. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. He finds an opening past the 40. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. That one 28 yards on the ground. So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. On second and 11 now, Prescott. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete.
That's it, baby.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down.
Here we go, 46.
Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Flushed out right. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. The sack coming from defensive end Cameron Jordan. It's fourth down.
Then we're going to 53.
Check three, check.
Then we're going to 53. Then we're going to 53.
Now Prescott on fourth down. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. A surprising move to go for it, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off, and the Saints will have the football back. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10. They begin on the ground with Kamara. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
95-56, no kill.
On second down at 4, Breeze. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. He was trying to get it that time to Ted Ginn. And it's 3rd and 4.
Hey, Orbit.
To throw is Breeze. And that is incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
They do go for it. It's Breeze. And he's got his tight end. That's Smith. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A gain of 26 and a conversion there as well on fourth down. Breeze now on first down. Looking for Thomas, but that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker Jalen Smith. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this first down carry, and that'll make it 2nd and 8. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they've got a 2nd and 8 forthcoming on second down. It's Elliott, and a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down. On third down, it's Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
And they'll get to this and touch it, looks like, yeah, right at the 15-yard line here. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, and balance.
Looking for Gannon, it's intercepted. Cheetah Bay Awuzie with a pick. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Prescott now. And that is caught. It's Witten for the Cowboy touchdown. Jason Witten there to make the grab as they are now on the board here in the first half. Extra point by Marr, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 the score as they begin 1st and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down.
Well, Charles, if you think so far the early part of the preseason, who has stood out? If you take a peek back at the draft, it really, the first round, it was pretty defensively minded. But there were 3 quarterbacks taken. Kyler Murray 1st, Daniel Jones 6th, Dwayne Haskins 15th. Of those guys, they look pretty good.
I agree with you, Brandon. When you talk about those 3 quarterbacks, and you're right, the rest of the draft, we're talking about big linemen, right? We're talking about defensive players, not a lot of skilled players in the first round. But let's take the quarterbacks very quickly. Kyler Murray, by acclamation, went to Arizona. Everyone excited about it. And I think his team remains excited about his prospects. They're eager to see him play. He became the starter as soon as he was drafted. Daniel Jones, that was a different situation in New York. The fans weren't real excited about him coming in. But the reason they drafted him has a similar demeanor and talent to Eli Manning, and he's acquitting himself quite nicely in the early going. And Dwayne Haskins a little more up and down in Washington, but they love the big arm of this guy, and he's back at home. Remember, he grew up in Potomac, Maryland.
On 1st down, Breeze. Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
Hey, easy. Right there, 54 miles. I'm coming. Check.
Now, Breeze again. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and short. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a pickup of 17 and a 1st down. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coaches.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Alvin Kamara with his 2nd touchdown here in this 1st half. And the Saints have taken the lead. Lutz with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. They run on first down, but it only produces a gain of 2. It's second down now. Give them a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Here's Prescott, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA, with a sack. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
He's got his target. It's Cobb. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. To throw is Prescott. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Prescott now from the 50, rolling to his right. He's going to look end zone here for Cooper. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Cooper was the target there. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. The loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. From the gun, it's Breeze. Off to Thomas on the left side. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. The final shot before half for Breeze. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, we got a second. We remind you that the Madden Championship Series is back and better than ever. August 30th through September 1st, you can watch the top Madden competitors face off in Arlington, Texas for a total prize pool of $190K. Tune in and watch it. Twitch.tv/EA Madden NFL, 2:30 p.m. Eastern, August 30th and 31st, and then 10:30 a.m. Eastern on September 1st to see if Skimbo can go back-to-back-to-back as a Madden Classic champion.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Prescott from the gun. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Cameron Jordan picks up his second sack of the afternoon. Out now comes the Cowboys punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Returnable for Sherrills. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points, and they'll look to add to that lead.
How about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Looking to throw on second down. Breeze. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
That's caught inside the 20. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. A big play. Breeze finding Thomas. 44 yards on the ground, Kamara. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Again, it's Kamara, and he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A 3-yard touchdown run, and the Saints able to stretch that lead out further.
Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players. And maybe...
And got his man complete! And that one results in 35 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. Cooper was the intended target. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Running with Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. He's got daylight. He's at the 40. 30. 10.
Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, 95 yards. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Lutz good on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. That's fielded in the end zone. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. Prescott to throw it, eluding the pressure right. He'll let this go for the... And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line. We're at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the New Orleans Saints. Elliott now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Ready. Yellow waiting, yellow waiting. 12, 12, 12.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of five. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him? Either fellow receivers or offensive linemen. That makes that play a really nice timing play. And sometimes it can break big.
And credit the tackle to Derek Barnett.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 15 yards on the play, first down. So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about three down to the 38.
Ready, 95-56. Hey, easy. Sammy. Hey, 5-7.
From the 38, Breeze over the middle. It's Jared Cook. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. 23 yards the pickup there.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a gain in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle. And if you can sting them there, that opens things up for you on the outside as well.
But that's where he, their big tight end, is so good, that middle third, the seam routes, the in routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well, and he's got it.
Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham. Throwing on second down, Breeze. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And it's third down.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Now they're coming up on play number eight of this opening drive, but they're looking at a third and long.
Easy, opposite. Check, 40. Bravo. You remember me. Let's go, baby. Jump. 41, Mike. I got wide.
So that'll back him up five. Ready. After the delay, they're backed up even further for third and long.
Tight end to the right.
Now Breeze. That's caught. It's Thomas. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Ready? 95-56.
They'll run it with Kamara. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara taking it in. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Lutz with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their own 22. Working from the gun, Wentz. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48. They could not ask for a worse start. You give up a touchdown on the game's opening drive, and then you turn right around and throw the interception on your very first play.
And this is where the coaching staff has to earn its money, because they've got to calm these guys down a little bit. Just as you noted, a horrendous start on both sides of the ball. But now the defense, which gave up an opening drive touchdown, they've got to go out there now and start playing like the team they want to be.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Give the tackle that time to Rodney McLeod. Looking to throw on second down. Breeze. That is caught. Traquan Smith. Touchdown Saints. Traquan Smith there to make the grab. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Lutz good on the extra point. And it's now 14 to nothing. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script play.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Sheldon Rankins abruptly ends that play with a sack. Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got it.
And Wentz will not be able to get rid of it. He's taken down for a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than two, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to six. I'm a former defender. Ooh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go four. I don't know about six.
Come on, come on. Come up to six.
A lot of points.
Ready.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
No gain on the play there. Second down. 16-0. That's the score after one on EA Sports. The Saints with a football here to begin quarter number two as they've got it with a second and 10. And he'll go down for a loss inside his own 5 at the 4. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone, so they could use something here on third down. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down.
Break it down, fellas. Break it down. Pilot, 64. Check curls.
They run. It's Kamara. And he'll have the first down as he's up to about the 18. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. 53. Off the play fake to Kamara, it's Breeze. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Fletcher Cox, the former Mississippi State Bulldog, ringing the cowbell there on the sack. And some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Now Breeze on 3rd down. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Nigel Bradham in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to 4th down. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And maybe getting a little too cute there on the punt return. Sometimes they forget paramount holding on to that football.
I really do believe most of the return guys think to themselves, when I get the ball, I'm going to make the play that's going to change the game.
I'm going
to break it. And you love that they have that attitude. But your point is so well taken. What do you have to do? First and foremost,
hold on to it.
Take care of the football. That's all he needed to do.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. To throw, it's Breeze. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
Been in the gym, jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit. Yeah, can't hit with anybody.
everybody take them, I can shake them. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them. I'ma break them. I'm a Hall of Fame legend, they should go and hang my jersey. Made to put in work, I don't think they really heard me. Like, move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. Ain't no stopping me, ain't no topping me. I am up, number one seed, ain't nobody popping up. Got a squad of gorillas from the jungle suited up. You kicking off against me, hope you ready, get it up. I be booted up, popping out a sprinter or a truck. Whole team chasing bags while they chasing us. Calling audible, I read the game, I think it's time to switch. You get hit, if I miss, then my teammates got the blitz, yeah. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Eno. Think I'm part Italian, blaming on Gino. Snowflake the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Had a genie with the snails in a five-star hotel. And I wish these well when they wish for me to fail. I might donate petty bills, they can't get it by theyself.
That's why you treat my friend good, but not too good. I give them too much, then they don't need me.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. I'ma get it either way. I don't even gotta say what I want, when I want. They just put it on my plate. I could get it right away. Take you through my day to day. Wake and pray, make that play. Get some good at my place. There's some on the way. Cause my bro's on the way. I got stones on my gold. I got loads in my safe. Had a 7-figure summer, so I'm putting on some weight. Set up getting thick, so I put it on display. Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
Level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched, and I better get set in. Finish him.
Mess around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I better kill them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen.
gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well, watch I eat now. Like, how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is a now. With state prop, you looking bleak now. I was home to sleep, designer sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew, it wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
Hey, how fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. Clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like. Fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like. Every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my number's going up. All these trophies, what do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now. You say that you ballin', keep it real though. Why I never saw you in the field though? Hey, I make it look easy, it's a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.
A lot of money, why are you mad like that?
Like that.
Ooh, ooh, I'm in my new bag, my bad.
You ain't get
too bad, my bad.
Yeah.
First of the month, I'm a running back.
Ay.
Same day, why I'm a running back?
Yeah.
Friday, payday, running back. Running back, running back, running back.
48 yards, I run it back.
Ay.
I cop a car, I run it back.
Yeah.
Go on your then run it back.
Running back, running back, running back.
Hello?
That's the Jag calling.
Dunk it. Let me click over. Quick
to let my check talk it, talk it,
I
talk
eat.
It.
Ooh, Pac-Man,
that's the way my neck talking.
Right,
I ain't never coming back. The way the stress.
You don't make no clap back when you backpack. My bad, but I'm past that. But an ass back, that's cash. When the money fall, I'ma slap that. Clap when the money go, you don't slap. That's facts. If the money low, I'ma grab. Raw man, when it come back, I'ma give back. My bad when the check hit, the direct hit. I'm glad when the check missed the direct hit. I'm sad like
who's that knocking at my window?
My window.
They say that it's the money. I'm like tenfold.
Over and out.
That's gonna make you up
like a limbo. She said she not a, she an. Ooh, ooh, why you do that like that? It's a lot of money, why are you mad like that? Ooh, I'm in my new bag, my bad. Too bad, my bad. First of the month, I'm a running back. Same day, why I'm a running back? Friday, payday, running back. Running back, running back, running back. 48 yards, I run it back. I cop a car, I run it back. Go on your then run it back. Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Yeah. Run up in a bitch mansion. Yeah. Run up in a bitch magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing. Now I hit the scene, they like lights, camera, action. Living in a dream, now my music, they be blasting. Step out, I'm a star, always in the latest fashion. Had to set the bar, try to catch me lacking. Bank account for my son, he won't have to struggle. You can see it in my eyes, all I do is hustle. They tried to knock me off my feet, I'm ready to rumble. Feel like I ain't ate in weeks, working off the muscle. Oh yeah, oh my, we ride. For my brothers, no lie, all you can die. Never wrong, they right, I ain't changing my side. Yeah, we in it for life. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laugh. Hey, how could you lie to my face? People claim that they be loyal, they be taking up space. See my broski lose his heart when he was fighting that case. Took so many yells, I'm not going back to those days. I'ma treat you how you treat me, do you like how it tastes? Shawty, use a, can't treat you like my ace. I got way too many problems to be worried, I'm straight. Me and Craig, had to watch for the Jakes. On the road, this road crazy, I get 80 a show. Save my money, stack it up, it look like I'm foreign cars driving fast, I never done this before. Get drown out my problems, let me run up in a bitch magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits. What would you do if you were me and didn't have it? Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laughing.
The throne. I ain't a king, not a pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the globe. I guess the world is my home, and there's so many milkers burning my dome, and like turbulent air, I'm switching these flows. If you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, as a vessel alone. They showing me love in my city. Gangs ain't hippies. Women like thinking know what I'm about. I'm not. The stereotypes, they do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Give everyone jobs. I'm not a guard. Go hop with a squad. I'm playing my part, but I'm LeBron. Wings of the team, I feel Jackson at heart. The homie calling from a cell. A couple of homies be making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well. Not worried about taking a couple of L's. Don't sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me. We eat together, leave the bill for me. Like,
hand on my heart. I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the top. Take a higher, that's a God. Hand on my heart. No, I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take a higher, that's a God. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost. Like, who do it better than me? Yeah. Vision on 2020. Yeah. BBS, Club D, yeah. Determination, laser focus. Banging on they. Though they taking notice.
Determination, laser focus, banging on they pump, they though they taking notice.
Just wanna be heard for your mom to your pop to the B to the bird. My cut right off on the curb like I'm Barry Sanders. Chains on and the diamonds dancing. Game on, so it's time to go. When the rain starts, I'ma let you know. Name a squad that is better though than my whole team. We a pot of gold. I'm a dog, dog. I'ma need a bone for my whole team. I'ma let it go like bow. Yeah, in the field like yeah, all day like yeah, all night like yeah, whole squad like what? In the field like yeah, all day like. I was waiting to shine. My father taught me don't be soft, so now I'm taking what's mine. I define myself as ambitious, young, black, and gifted. Masterpiece, my masterpiece, that mean I don't got no limits. Bout it, I doubt it. My homies know you ain't ratted. We break you down like a pound. I got it, don't pound us around me. I'm corrupted, flow cold and it's rugged, bumpy. What is up? I'm ready for all you got to love it. Like, blah, yeah, in the field like, yeah, all day like, yeah. Squad like what? In the field like yeah, all day like yeah, all night like what? Whole squad like yeah, in the field like yeah, all day like yeah, all night like yeah, whole squad like yeah, in the field like yeah, all day like yeah, all night like yeah.
You don't want problems, you don't want smoke dogs, you don't want problems. Yeah, you don't want problems.
I gotta get it, you hating because I still know this. Why but you want to be famous, huh? They elevated us, huh? You know I'm pricey in Vegas, huh? This for the haters, huh? I make a lot of new money, huh? When the not save us, huh? You be liking my flavor, huh? I think it's God. I just want to know it.
Since I blew, they all on my hey, back then, didn't know I exist. Don't touch my cup, you know how I sip. Hey, got your long say I made her when I showed out my whip. Hey, spent my 10 on my 50. Act slick, then hit with the back then, you out the zip. Blow out his back, then dip. Got a whole party all on the ship. All these four things pull out the vip. Suck, turn up, baby, pour out the milk. Say you know how I drip. Crush.
Check the wrist, man. Got him hot, ayy. Man can't ball like this, man. Lord, pass the pigskin when he stretch a distance. I'm talking a few 100,000 yards. You just on your fifth grand. Run it up, 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 count it up. Ayy, hundreds and fifties and twenties, no fives and no singles. Don't count on them. Ayy, she want it like me because her like she can't count on him. She try to be nosy and hit on my ex. She like, girl, you can count on him.
Ayy, ayy. We need more. Tell him we need more. Putting numbers on the board. Like 16 cars in my front yard, hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet points of God.
Big numbers, big numbers, 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers, whole team count it, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers, 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, blue hunts, whole team count.
Yeah, honey, I dash. Yeah, honey, I dash. Got it on smash. Foot on the gas.
I will not crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone. Watch me, celebrate. I'm cocky. I do my dance. Jump in the stands. No man, a man. Odell with the hands. Thought he could guard me. I ruin they plans. I do what I want. They do what they can. Got it on smash. Put on the gas. I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash. 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 Yeah. They can't catch up cause they lacking the stamina. Way too advanced to be playing with amateurs. They on attack when they tackle like damager. They react and play it back on the camera. Hot boy, just consider me flammable. Sure shot, I got all the intangibles. Need a leash, I'm a beast, I'm an animal. Heat the competition up like a Hannibal. Know the game like I wrote up the manual. I do weekly what you do on the annual. MVP, that decision unanimous. Big dogs, I don't think they can handle it. Battlefield, it's just me and my warriors. Guaranteed we emerging victorious. Years blessed, sweat, tears, it's glorious. I remember when they all was ignoring us.
Dash, got it on smash. Foot on the gas, I will not crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone. Watch me, celebrate. I'm cocky. I do my dance. Jump in the stands. No man, a man. Odell with the hands. Thought he could guard me. I ruin they plans. I do what I want. They do what they can. Got it on smash. Put on the gas. I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash.
They slept on the team that they owe me.
Give me that.
I need a ring and a trophy. I say I'm the best cause I am. It's no need in keeping it low-key. I can carve up the D like a turkey. I run straight through the D like a train. This year we ain't taking no losses. It's all about making the game. I hear a lot of trash talk. He call himself making a name. I put on the jets. The coach will regret even letting him stay in the game. Team morale took a tumble. Next time be humble. I'm the lion in the jungle. Trying not to fumble, rumble, young man, rumble. Never slip nor stumble. I take off, poof, magic. Now watch me juke through the traffic. Footwork fantastic, dominating every facet. Treat the pocket like plastic. Pick on the blitz, pass it. Got it on smash. Put on the gas. I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash.
Yeah. Okay, 30,000 in the pocket, no change. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay, all my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay, so when I die, I ain't gonna be from old age. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Right pocket got euros, left pocket got pound, pound. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Throw the ball with the right hand, catch with the left, touchdown. Step back, let me get some room. Congrats every time I'm through. Same packing nobody new, so I never get confused. Hotel, get a bird's eye view. Hotel, get a waiting room. Read a magazine while you wait for me. Baby, y'all be done so soon. Phone gotta be off, each door got locks. I got some trusted shoes.
Okay.
10K on the countertop, don't look so shocked. It's nothing new.
Okay.
Death comes in threes.
Three.
Wins come in twos.
Two.
Cash comes in ones. One. Throw it up, celebrate some news.
Hey.
I do a good job. Pull up and pop out and pull off. Hat on and hood on. Pedal to metal. When I put my foot on, I got to put on. I got a bad one. They want to keep me. Oh, that's a good one. Pockets are dense. I think my bread is hard as a crouton. Receipts in my pocket don't come with a coupon.
Aye, yeah.
Okay. 30,000 in the pocket. No change. Okay. I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay. All my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay. So when I die, I ain't gonna be from old age. Somebody gonna want revenge. Somebody might want it now. Right pocket got euros. Left pocket got pound. Somebody gonna want revenge. Somebody might want it now. Throw the ball with the right hand, catch with the left, touchdown. Touchdown, A floor, come down. Hotel, lobby. Receptionist, what now? 11 a.m., check out. Might give her one foul, just to tell her it's one now. How come? I need rest, no recess in my schedule.
Right.
Mama used to serve vegetables, now half the meals got tentacles.
Right.
Half the Emirates need a reservation, and half my money goes straight to taxes. But I don't trip about it, that's what happens when you got dreams closer than a match. Plus all your boys got expensive habits.
Go.
I know what they're thinking, they don't even gotta say it.
Nope.
They thinking they just made it. I know how to make everybody feel famous.
Famous.
I don't gotta work no day shift.
Day shift.
I don't gotta split no payment.
Payment.
I don't gotta answer questions.
Right.
And I don't need you to okay it.
Yeah.
Okay, 30,000 in the pocket, no change. Okay, I might pass the ball, but this is no game. Okay, all my girls, they love and hate me the same. Okay, so when I die, I ain't gonna be from old age. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Right pocket got euros, left pocket got pound, pound. Somebody gonna want revenge, somebody might want it now. Throw the ball with the right hand, catch with the left, touchdown.
Touchdown.
They can't take it to 10.
Hey.
Ain't got time for no debating. It's for the taking. No hesitation. Don't try my patience. I'ma pour out one for the set, boy, till there's nothing left. On a run to the bread until we all got them baguettes. Hear them footsteps coming, cause we coming for the check.
We ain't gon' run, no, we don't hide. I could never switch, not a day in my life. Long as my dogs stay by my side. We die, die, die. We ain't gon' run, no, we gon' hide. I can never switch, not a day in my life. As long as my dogs stay by my side. Yeah, we gon' ride till we die, die, die.
Working, that's the promise. Going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm going big. Going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Way too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick. Acting like they know me, cause I'm
PPP love. Time to bring the bass back. Get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard. My team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is. Now get it. Big Snoop Dogg. It's in the game.
The Pelly Show, this so perennial. Do this for my millennials. I be murdering.